loose on the momentum of teenage nightmares. Your breasts hang like a woman's, and you don't jump at shadows anymore. Instead, you may simply pause to admire those that move with the grace of trees dancing past streetlights. And you walk through your house without turning on lamps, sure of the angle from door to table, from table to staircase, sure of the number of steps sudden to the landing, two to turn right, then suddenly more. Sure that you will stroll serenely on the moving walkway of memory across your bedroom and collapse with a sigh under your bed, shoes falling, thunk, thunk, onto the floor, and there will be no strange man. Suddenly all that time sitting there on what must be a prized chair in your collection of uncomfortable chairs, with a wild look in his eyes and hands that you cannot see, holding what you do not know. So sure are you of the endless drumming rhythm of your isolation, you are painfully slow to adjust. If only because yours is not that genre of story. Still and again, life cannot muster the stuff of movies, no bullets shattering glass. Instead, fear sits patiently. Fear almost smiles when you finally see it, though you have kept him waiting for 33 years, and now he has let himself in, and he's brought you fistfuls of teenage.